Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilpandi. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject heat and mass transfer. And this is lecture number 110 on the module 1 conduction heat transfer. This is lecture number 10, critical radius of insulation. So we recap from the previous lecture. We studied the steady state heat transfer in cylinder and sphere with the internal heat generation. So the heat is generated within the solid, and we calculated the surface temperature, center temperature and rate of heat transfer. Now here, to the extension of the previous lecture, the critical radius of insulation. Electrical wires, there are some wires without insulation, open wire, overhead wires, or the household wires are insulated. So what would be the thickness of the insulation? What would be the radius of the insulation? How to calculate the critical radius of insulation in the case of electrical wire or cable? Similarly, in the power plant, the steam, hot fluid steam, is taken from one place to another place through the pipeline. Again, the pipes are insulated. There again, what would be the thickness of the insulation? How to calculate the thickness of the insulation? So, what is the effect of increasing the thickness or reducing the thickness on the heat transfer process, or the effect of the insulation on the heat transfer in the pipeline or electrical wire? So we will discuss the calculation of critical radius of the insulation here in this topic, and the learning outcome for the student at the end of this lecture. The student will be able to calculate critical radius of insulation for cylinder and sphere and determine the rate of heat transfer. So we take a pipeline of radius, outer radius R1, or you take a wire of outer radius R1, it is insulated with a material of thermal conductivity K, and the outer radius of the insulation is R2, and you have the convection heat transfer coefficient. And the heat is generated, for example, in the case of electrical wire, when the current is flowing through the wire, the heat is generated. So the loss of electricity, it is in the form of heat, and the heat is to be dissipated to the surrounding. The heat is to be removed from the electrical wire. If the heat is in an insulated cable, in an insulated wire, when the heat is not removed properly, it will increase the temperature of the wire. Because of the higher temperature, the wire will melt and leads to discontinuity of the wire. So the proper heat removal from the electrical wire is important. And the heat transfer here is, there are two resistances for the heat transfer from the wire to the surrounding. And look at here. So the first, the resistance due to the insulation, across the insulation, the conduction resistance. And we have the surrounding with the conduction resistance. So the two resistances are the resistance, conduction resistance across the insulating material, and the convection resistance on the surface of the insulation. And when you change the radius, R2, when the R2 is increasing, so look at this equation, R1, when the R2 is increasing, the heat transfer is increasing and it takes a maximum value and then it decreases. So technically, the radius corresponding to the maximum heat transfer, it is called as critical radius of insulation. So R2C K by H. So which is calculated by, which is not mentioned as K by H. So when you range, actually what is the outer radius of insulation? That is what our question, that is calculated by K by H. K is the thermal conductivity of the insulating material and H is the heat transfer coefficient. So, how to calculate all these values? So, we will see one by one. the rate of heat transfer from the cylinder, from the sphere or a cylinder. So for this situation, it is given by T1 minus T infinity divided by resistance due to the insulation plus resistance due to the convection. So here K is the thermal conductivity, L is the length of the wire, H is the heat transfer coefficient, and R2 is the only variable. So R2 is the radius of the insulation. Increasing R2 will increase the conduction resistance. So this resistance will increase and decreases the convection resistance because the area is increasing. So the convection resistance will decrease. And for optimum value of R2, we have to differentiate this equation with respect to R2 and equal to 0. So for differentiation, numerator is a constant. So we differentiate only the denominator. So d by dr2 of the entire denominator 1 by 2 pi kl into logarithmic of r2 minus r1 plus 1 by 2 pi r2 into l into h equal to 0. So differentiating 2 pi kl, so this will give you, so ln r2 minus ln r1, ln r2 is 1 by r2, ln r1 equal to 0, differentiate ln r1 equal to 0 plus 1 by 2 pi l into h, differentiating 1 by r2 equal to minus 1 by r2 square. And the rearranging the terms, so this term, you have a negative sign here, you take to the other side, and simplifying, we will get 1 by k equal to 1 by h into r2, and rearranging r2c equal to k by h for the cylinder. And similarly for sphere, with the same kind of calculation, when you do the c sphere, replacing this value for resistance for the sphere, and doing the same mathematical operation, we will get R2C equal to 2K by H. So the critical radius is K by H. So what is the significance of the critical value? So for the cylindrical pipe, the radius of insulation is greater than the critical radius of critical radius, the heat transfer will decrease. So you know the pipe diameter, pipe radius. So you have to add insulation. When you add the insulation, then the heat transfer will decrease. That is what expected in a steam pipe. In a steam pipe, the heat loss to the surrounding from the pipe should be minimum. In the case of cable and wire, if the wire radius is smaller, then the insulation may be applied up to the critical radius to increase the heat transfer. So, very thin wire. So, for a thin wire, you have to add insulation to the critical value so that the heat transfer will increase. If the wire radius is more than the critical radius, then addition of insulation will reduce the heat transfer, causes overheating of wire and cable. So that is why the overhead wires, overhead cables are not insulated, because the outer radius of the wire is more than the critical radius of insulation. So in that case, when you insulate, so the heat temperature of the wire will increase. That is why overhead wires are not insulated. Household wires are very smaller in diameter, they are being insulated. And we'll take a few examples to understand the concept. Calculate critical radius of insulation for asbestos of K equal to 0.172 watts per meter Kelvin surrounding a pipe and exposed to room air at 300 Kelvin with the heat transfer coefficient H equal to 2.8 watts per meter square Kelvin. Calculate heat loss from a 475 Kelvin 60 mm diameter pipe when covered with critical radius of insulation and without insulation. So the given data, the temperature of the pipe, pipeline is 475 Kelvin, a radius equal to 0.03 meter, and fluid temperature is 300 Kelvin, heat transfer coefficient is 2.8 watts per meter square Kelvin, and thermal conductivity of the material, insulating material, is 0.172 watts per meter Kelvin. So for the pipe, the critical radius of insulation R2C equal to K by H, which is 0.172 divided by 2.8 equal to 0.061 meter, and the heat transfer without insulation, which is HCA into delta T, so H into 2 pi R1 into L into T1 minus T infinity, so substituting numerical values, so this is 92.3 watts. So 2.8 into 2 into pi into R1 equal to 0.01, length of the wire, length of the pipe is 1 meter, and the 475 minus 300, that gives 92.3 watts. And the heat transfer with the insulation, so Q equal to T1 minus T infinity divided by 1 by 2 pi KL logarithmic of R2C by R1 plus 1 by 2 pi R2L into H. Substituting all the numerical values, so this will be 110.1 watts. So adding the insulation, heat transfer increases. So the answer to the problem, heat transfer without insulation is 92.3 watts and heat transfer with insulation is 110.1 watts. We take another example, an electrical wire of 10 meter length and 1 mm diameter dissipates 200 watts in air at 220 degrees Celsius. The convection heat transfer coefficient between the wire surface and the air is 15 watts per meter square Kelvin. Calculate the critical radius of insulation and also determine the temperature of the wire if it is insulated to the critical thickness of insulation. Take thermal conductivity of the material is 0.5 watts per meter Kelvin. And the given data for the problem, length of the wire is 10 meter, radius equal to 0.0005 meter. T infinity, fluid temperature is 20 degrees Celsius, heat transfer coefficient is 15 watts per meter square Kelvin, and thermal conductivity is 0.5 watts per meter Kelvin, the heat transfer is 200 watts. The critical radius of insulation for the wire, R2C equal to K by H, which is 0.5 divided by 15, which is 0.0333. And the heat transfer with the insulation, so you write the equation Q equal to T1 minus T infinity divided by 1 by 2 pi KL logarithmic of R2C by R1 plus 1 by 2 pi R2 into L into H. So the Q equal to 200. Substituting other values, we can calculate the T1 value. So T1 equal to T1 minus 20 divided by the denominator. Calculating the denominator, it is 0.0989. So solving this equation, T1 equal to 39.8 degree Celsius. And the temperature of the wire is 39.8 degrees Celsius. And we take the third example, a conductor with a diameter of 0.8 centimeter carrying an electric current passes through an ambient at 30 degrees Celsius with the heat transfer coefficient 120 watts per meter square Kelvin. The temperature of the conductor is maintained at 130 degrees Celsius. Calculate the rate of heat loss per meter length of the conductor for the conductor is bare. And two, the conductor is covered with the backlit insulation with the thermal conductivity 1.2 watts per meter Kelvin with the radius corresponding to the critical radius of insulation. And the temperature T1 equal to given data, temperature T1 equal to 130 degrees Celsius, R1 radius equal to 0.004 meter, and T infinity fluid temperature is 30 degrees Celsius, heat transfer coefficient is 120 watts per meter square Kelvin, and thermal conductivity is 1.2 watts per meter Kelvin. And the critical radius of insulation for the conductor, R2C equal to K by H equal to 1.2 divided by 120 equal to 0.01. And heat transfer without insulation, so H into 2 pi R1 into L into T1 minus T infinity, substituting 120 into 2 pi into 0.004 into 130 minus 30 equal to 301.44 watts. Then heat transfer with insulation, so Q equal to T1 minus T infinity, divided by 1 by 2 pi KL logarithmic of R2C by R1 plus 1 by 2 pi R2 into L into H. So substituting numerical value 130 minus 30 divided by 1 by 2 pi into 1.2, thermal conductivity is 1.2 into 1, the logarithmic of 0.01 divided by 0.004 plus 1 by 2 pi into 0.01 into L equal to 1 meter into heat transfer coefficient 120 equal to 393.2 watts. And the heat transfer without insulation is 301.44 watts and heat transfer with insulation is 393.2 watts. And we take another example, an electrically heated sphere of with a diameter 6 cm is exposed to ambient at 25 degrees Celsius with the H value equal to 20 watts per meter square Kelvin. The temperature of the sphere is maintained at 125 degrees Celsius. Calculate the rate of heat loss from the sphere for 1, the sphere is bare, and 2, sphere is covered with insulation of thermal conductivity 1 watts per meter Kelvin with the radius corresponding to the critical radius of the sphere. So the given data, temperature of the surface of the sphere is 125 degrees Celsius, the radius of the sphere is 0.03 meter, T infinity fluid temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, heat transfer coefficient is 20 watts per meter square Kelvin, and the thermal conductivity of the insulating material is 1 watts per meter Kelvin. And critical radius of insulation for the sphere R2C equal to 2K by H, which is 2 into 1 divided by 20 equal to 0.1 meter. And the heat transfer without insulation, Q equal to H into 4 pi R1 square area of the sphere into T1 minus T infinity equal to 20 into 4 pi into 0.03 square into 125 minus 25 equal to 22.61 watts. And the heat transfer with the insulation, Q equal to T1 minus T infinity divided by 1 by 4 pi K into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2C plus 1 by 4 pi into R2C square into H. So, substituting numerical values, 125 minus 25 divided by 1 by 4 pi into K equal to 1 and multiplied by 1 by 0.03 minus 1 by 0.1 plus 1 by 4 pi into 0.1 square into 20, the heat transfer equal to 44.33 watts. And the answers to the problem, heat transfer without insulation is 22.61 watts and heat transfer with insulation is 44.3 watts. So, we stop here. And these are all the books I have used for preparation, and you can refer to it for additional information. And I have published a book on the subject, Heat and Mass Transfer, published by another publication, Chennai. You can reach to it to get additional problem. And you can write to me for any queries on the subject to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer to all your queries. Thank you. We'll meet again.